In 1885, Texas-based pharmacist Charles Alderton created a drink that would soon become one of the most popular drinks in the world. While working at Morrison's Old Corner Drugstore in Waco, Texas, Alderton would create new flavors for carbonated drinks. At the time, sodas were meant to make medicines more palatable, but more and more people began to start drinking them as a refreshing drink. And then one day, Alderton mixed together 23 different fruit flavors, and customers loved it. The owner of the store, Morrison, decided to name the new flavor Dr. Pepper, naming it after the father of a woman who he once was in love with. The syrup became so successful that every restaurant in Waco that had a soda fountain wanted that syrup. But Alderton didn't really want to take the Dr. Pepper brand any further. So he sold it to Morrison and a local beverage chemist called Robert Lazenby in 1891. Together, they worked to improve the drink, and by 1904, Dr. Pepper was released to the world in the World Fair Exposition in St. Louis. And people absolutely loved it. Originally marketed as having tonic and energizing properties, Dr. Pepper soon began growing in popularity right beside the other types of sodas such as Coca-Cola. And speaking of, after a lengthy legal battle with Coca-Cola, Dr. Pepper was declared a non-cola drink, which allowed Dr. Pepper to be bottled in the same facility as Coca-Cola. This was huge as it expanded Dr. Pepper's success and footprint across the United States. And after going through several mergers, one of the most important ones was 7-Up, Dr. Pepper is still going strong with its parent company, Keurig Dr. Pepper. And as of 2019, Keurig Dr. Pepper is the third largest soft drink company in the world and the largest that is not trading under the cola name. It is valued at $38.8 billion and still going strong. And that's how Dr. Pepper started. Thank you for watching my video. If you enjoyed it, please subscribe to me on YouTube and follow me on Instagram at AustinDanielPetrie.